they realize, being in their culture, and hey, there's some value in education. United States, sometimes we don't value it. Ms. Corliss had a guest speaker last week and said, made the point of, in old times you had students, when they were being trained by their rabbi or their teacher, the first thing they had to do when they get up in the morning is they have to quote everything that they learned the day before, or they couldn't get out and go to class or to work or whatever. They had to quote that information. And my thought instantly went to our school, our high school students in America now, they just say, great, I won't quote anything, I'll just be able to stay in bed. Is that we don't always value education, the opportunity to learn, where some of these other countries now do. They value education more than we do. Just some things to consider.
Do you think if you were one of these players that you would agree with what you're stating today? No disrespect, but I don't see any of the four of you going directly to the NBA or anything like that. Would you feel differently if you could put that hat on for a second and be the number one recruit coming out of high school? And you would want to, what's that?
Disagree with what?
The fact that you disagree.
Like, if I was the best
paying college athletes, say if you went to college, you were a big time recruit, big time athlete, would you then go, well, no, I do think they got to be paid?
Well, if there's.
I guess my point is, are you thinking of this as you in your specific situation, or if you tried to put on the hat of one of these people, I guess I'm speaking directly to the paying of college athletes, would you go, wait a second, hold on, at the University of Kentucky, I'm bringing in. You have 24,000 people coming to watch me play, and I'm one of the 7 or 8 that they're coming to watch. Coach Cal's getting $8 million a year, and I get to go to the student union and have my dinner tonight.
So, I mean, at the end of the year, then I'd have the Barnstorm money, and then I'd be making a few $1 million in the kid.
So you feel like you would feel the same as you're stating right now, even if you were one of those?
I don't know what I'm stating right now, though.
Did you think that? You all stated that we shouldn't be paying college athletes.
Yeah.
Would you feel differently if you were one of the people that's on a plane on CBS every weekend? Do you feel like you would have the same opinion?
Yeah.
What about you?
Probably would disagree with myself.
Okay. Fair enough.
Yeah. But if I could go out of high school, I would just do that. If I'm that good.
Right. If we still had the one and done, like it is now.
Okay.
How upset would you be if you felt like you had the ability to be a lottery pick out of high school?
I'd just go to college and play, I guess.
Roll with it?
Yeah. Do they get paid in the G League?
They get paid, but it's not a ton of pay. It's about $30,000
a year. That's what some kids are doing. I mean, this year, there's like 2 kids, I think, or a couple of kids. Darius Baisley's one of them. They're going, Schmidler's not going to college. They can't go right out of high school.
A couple went over and played in China.
Yeah.
Right up in college.
Yes. And then we got the Ball Brothers. Going to Latvia.
They're a case study in and of themselves.
Yeah.
Do you ever foresee U.S. collegiate sports going the way of Australia and places like that? And it's just club sports where you can make money playing as a club, but you're not attaching to the college itself. Do we ever get so out of balance that that's the model we end up using?
I think we're going that way. I'm pretty sure they are.
So the rest of the world is that way. We're the only ones that have it this way.
Good. That's how it should be.
Let's put it in perspective here. In University of Kentucky, getting ready to tear down the cliff, a nice baseball stadium, to build a nicer baseball stadium. What's the real purpose when we really don't fulfill and sell out the cliff right now? Is that a model that's out of balance?
That would probably be more like a recruiting piece
for a sport that doesn't generate.
Yeah.
activity, just not more than it is meant.
But that kind of shows you, you know, I love baseball, I love UK baseball, but that kind of shows you how warped we are. We're doing it only for one reason, that's for recruits and for pride and, you know, that part of it. We can compete with everybody else, the Alabamas, the Floridas.
If you were paying college athletes and the way you recruit, would that change? So all of a sudden, would you also be able to start paying high school athletes to help develop them? Any compensation there because they're about to, they commit to your school?
You could have bleed over into high school.
I don't think you're saying like.
Why not?
During high school?
Mm-hmm.
Is there not?
That would be like.
Not bringing barely any revenue in.
But they're about
to. It's like the state champion.
Best high school player on the planet. You want to for sure lock him into your school.
Oh, like a college actually pay him just to come there? Okay, I could see that. Yes. I thought you meant like paying them for.
So during their college career, you see a lot of promise.
Yes.
Yeah. And you want to for sure lock them in as a college. And so could you ever see a day where the college then takes it back down a level and says, you're a junior, you can throw 9 miles an hour in basketball, sign now and we will compensate you between now and the time you start school. Is that a good thing?
Well, not a good thing.
No, why not?
I don't know, just, I mean, if they're an adult, if they're 18.
They're not at this point, they're a kid.
I just see problems erupting, for sure.
And if you are paying college athletes, and the college athlete is injured, and no longer can play, say, a basketball player, and so he's getting probably the biggest salary in the school, but he can, as a college athlete, can no longer play. What do you think would be a likely scenario there?
Going off the revenue thing, I mean, quality paid, I'd say the stopping as much as they are, or trophies don't pay.
Zero.
I know you guys said you talked to Coach Valentine and you mentioned Coach Siemens a few minutes ago. How do you think your other high school coaches feel about this? I think I could guess where Coach Galley feels just based on some of the things he said, but how do you think some of your other coaches feel about this? Either the one and done or paying college athletes, you can kind of take your pick.
I'm pretty sure most of my coaches, the coaches here, would be against paying college athletes. For sure.
What about one and done?
I think that.
I'd say a lot of coaches would want their kids to go out of high school if they're that good.
You think your coach would be okay with?
Yeah, Coach Lee said he would rather play with him, go out of high school than be forced to waste it, basically.
All right, guys, we're less than a minute. Anything that you want to say that you didn't get to say today? Chance. Speak now or forever hold your peace.
It's going to be hard. Anybody's mind change as you went through the process?
Thanks,
Alice.
Appreciate it.